Good morning, everyone. And let's see. All right. Let's see. I feel like we were just here. That's what I'm looking for. Okay. Outstanding. All right. Good morning to all of you, wherever you are at. I think every once in a while we will say that God is in his holy temple. Let us all keep silent before him. And we have to remember that our temple is not on the street corner here in Shreveport, 1603 Rex. A street corner isn't where you might go to church. We are the temple. We are the sanctuary. And today is the day that we are inviting the Spirit of God to enter into us, to guide us into this world that we have never seen before. And if we have any question about whether or not we need God, you probably haven't turned on your TV yet. But if you don't think you need God, if you don't think you need Christ, then I need you to call me so you can explain to me how you're making it. You are not making it by your wits. You're not making it by your wallet. You are making it by the grace of God. And so we are here this morning to celebrate him and to give him the praise that he is due for being so good to us. Because it's definitely not because we are so good. It's not because we got it this morning. It's not because we dressed up this morning. It's because he is that good. And because he's that good, we're going to celebrate him. And so I want to thank you for your presence here. And what I want to do is encourage you from wherever you are at to lift up God for all that he is worth. We talk about getting excited, and boy, if we were in church, woo, we'd pray and we'd shout. Well, what are we waiting for? If we need other people around to make us shout, then we're not shouting for God. We're shouting for the other people just so that they can tell us how holy we are. Didn't you see Reverend Payne shout? He was shouting. But somehow when we were at home, we sit there and just kind of look. And so he's the same God if we were in the sanctuary as he is in our living rooms, in our dining rooms, and wherever we happen to be. And so I just want to encourage you today to worship God for all he's worth, because I'm pretty sure he's worth everything. And so with that introduction, and I see a couple of y'all going ahead and give him a hand clap of praise, and I appreciate that. We thank you and we praise you. And let's see. Minister Brian, are you on yet? I don't think he is. Let's see. Well, we're going to go ahead and, as we did last night, Sister Trishawn Fuller, are you on? Can you come on and just go ahead and give us our opening prayer?
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Good morning.
Holy and omnipotent Father, righteous Redeemer, and author and finisher of our faith, we give you praise and thanks this morning, for you alone are worthy. Oh God, we love you and we praise you and we set our hearts on you this morning as we sit at your feet. God, we want to thank you for bringing us through another conference year. You've been so faithful and so merciful to this body of believers. God, as we prepare to enter into a new conference year, show us a more excellent way. Give us divine insight on how to reach the lost, God. Help us to become better fishermen because the world is in desperate need of the message of Christ. God, I know it's no surprise to you that the world is in crisis. So this morning, we're going to take off our camouflage and just admit to you that sometimes we feel helpless, powerless, and hopeless. God, I ask for you to speak to our situations and show yourself strong in our lives. God, help us to remember that you hold the world in your hands and everything is under your command. God, we ask that you give us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us. God, sanitize our spirits, disinfect our hearts, give us clean hands so that we will be better prepared to serve you. God, give us a greater impulse to pray, fast, and seek your face. In the name of Jesus, I pray this morning. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Sister Fuller. Minister Bryant, I see you out there. Will you please come and give us a song before the scripture?
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Hope everyone is doing okay this morning. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you care for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. My heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. You paid the price for me way back on Calvary. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. I love you. I love you, Lord, today. Because you cared for me in such a special way. That's why I praise you. I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. That's why my heart is filled with praise. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Amen. Amen. Sister Virginia Lampkins, will you please come with our scripture for the day? And you're muted still.
Okay. I will be reading today from Philippians, first chapter, the 12th through the 26th verses. Now I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that what has happened to me has actually served to advance the gospel. As a result, it has become clear throughout the whole palace guard and to everyone else that I am in chains for Christ. And because of my chains, most of the brothers and sisters have become confident in the Lord and dare all the more to proclaim the gospel without fear. It is true that some preach Christ out of envy and rivalry, but others out of goodwill. The latter do so out of love, knowing that I am but here for the defense of the gospel. The former preach Christ out of selfish ambition, not sincerely, supposing that they can stir up trouble for me while I am in chains. But what does it matter? The important thing is that in every way, whether from false motives or true, Christ is preached. And because of this, I rejoice. Yes, and I will continue to rejoice. For I know that through your prayers and God's provision of the Spirit of Jesus Christ, what has happened to me will turn out for my deliverance. I eagerly expect and hope that I will in no way be ashamed, but will have sufficient courage so that now as always, Christ will be exalted in my body, whether by life or death. For to me, to live is Christ, and to die is gain. If I am to go on living in the body, this will mean fruitful labor for me. Yet what shall I choose? I do not know. I am torn between the two. I desire to part and be with Christ, which is better by far. But it is more necessary for you that I remain in the body. Convinced of this, I know that I will remain and I will continue with all of you for your progress and joy in the faith, so that through my being with you again, your boasting in Christ Jesus will abound on account of me. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen. Blessed be the name of God. Minister Bryant, will you please come back and give us another song?
Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Forever you are the same. We worship and adore you. We bow ourselves before you, giving you the glory that is due your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Forever you are the same. We worship and adore you. We bow ourselves before you, giving you the glory that is due your name. I think I'll say that again. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Forever you. We worship and adore you. We bow ourselves before you, giving you the glory that is due your name. We magnify your name. Glorify your name. Oh God. We magnify your name. By your name. Oh God, we magnify your name, glorify your name, oh magnify your name, glorify your name, oh God. We magnify your name, glorify. Glorify your name, oh God.
Amen. Amen. Stand by one. All right. Thank you. Thank you, Minister Bryant. And thank you to Sister Lampkins and to Sister Fuller for their participation in the service. Real quick, let me run through our announcements. Let's see. The Women's Book Club Bible study is postponed. They were supposed to start tonight, but we're going to push that off till next Sunday. So next Sunday, so there will be no Women's Book Club Bible study. Hopefully everybody got the book. The book is If I Run by Terry Blackstock, and they will be looking at chapters 1-5 next Sunday. So next Sunday, 6 p.m., right here on this same bat channel. The brothers, we will be having Bible study tomorrow night at 6:30. I think we are in Leviticus 26. And so we're going to continue to study that. I will go ahead and say this, that the Cowboys will be playing tomorrow night. And so we will have a special prayer service because they need all the help they can get. And so I encourage all the brothers to join us tomorrow night for Bible study to help the pastor pray for his Cowboys because they need a lot of prayer. So please join us. And even if you don't want to stay for Bible study, join us for the prayer part because, yeah. And then on Wednesday night, we will have Bible study. I do want to thank Brother Wade Hall for stepping in. We've got a huge project going on at my job. We got off on time on Tuesday, and Wednesday at 6 o'clock, we were still knee deep in work. And I was like, I just can't leave. I called Brother Wade and he was out driving. So I said to the Sister Smith, just go ahead and cancel Bible study. And so I didn't even know you guys were having Bible study until I got off, and I didn't even leave the office until 8 p.m. that night. And so I thank God that the word still went forth. I do apologize for all those who tuned into Facebook looking for Bible study because we've got to do better so that this monkey here doesn't stop the circus because everything's set up and I know how everything's set up. And so I do apologize for those who missed Bible study, but we will be in Bible study this Wednesday night. Which is kind of unusual because we also have annual conference this week. And because we're not going anywhere and because we're not having a service that night, we will still have Bible study. So I do encourage you to join us at 6:30 on Wednesday night. Let's see, speaking of annual conference, let's see if I can make this work. want to bring this up here. This week, annual conference, and we want to make this relatively big so everybody can see it. So annual conference starts this week. It will be on the 22nd, and we will have registration from 7:30 to 8:30. Now, the thing I really need to make clear is Zoom will be pretty much closed, and only those who, the pastors, the preachers, the delegates, those conference officers will be on Zoom. Everybody else will have to watch the conference from Facebook. It will be on the 8th District AME Church Facebook page. And so I encourage you to go out there and watch the service or watch what's going on. You can see the order that it's going to be starting at officially the devotion will start at 8:30. Business will start at 8:45. And then if I go down to the next page, you should be able to see, actually, if I get this stuff off my screen so you can actually see it. Ooh, not that. Let's see here. No, I don't want to do that. All right. Never mind. Oh, and I moved it off so you can't really see it. Oh boy, technology got to love it. All right. So where most people are concerned with, I highlighted the things that most people are concerned with as far as annual conference goes. 11:15, the opening worship service will begin. At 1:30, we'll do the business session, which will include the pastors and the literary reports. And then the closing commissioning service will be at 5:30 p.m. And we will also have the reading of the appointments. And so again, this will be Facebook Live. We will be here all day online. Some of us will be on Zoom. If you have any questions about this, please let me know. Also, the Women's Missionaries Society, the lay organization, and those other organizations will be meeting on the 22nd. I do believe you have to have been registered for those. And so if you have a question about registration, especially for the WMS, please contact Sister Virginia Lampkins, and she can let you know whether or not you still can register for the Women's Missionary Society portion of the conference. And so it is our prayer that that night the bishop will say, the Reverend Robert Payne Jr., this is to certify that the Reverend Robert Payne Jr. has been appointed to the pastorate of St. Mary AME Church, Shreveport. So that is our prayer. Y'all, this week, I don't care if you have to fast, pray, roll over, stand up, stand on your head, whatever you do, you lift that up to God, that will be the intent of the bishop's heart. And we will hear that on Thursday night. And let's see. Early voting has started. Early voting has started in Louisiana. I think Florida, you guys start on Monday, if you haven't already mailed in your ballot. So early voting has started. If you have not voted, again, have a plan to vote. You still have some time. But I do also want to encourage you that this vote, and I've said it before, I'll say it again, is about more than the presidency. We, especially here in Louisiana, we've got some, they want to make some amendments to the Constitution. There are some Senate seats that are being voted on. And so I need you to go in there and thinking beyond Trump and Biden, Kanye West, and everybody else who happens to be on the ballot. But I need you thinking beyond that, because there are other things going on. So please get the Go Vote out, G-E-A-U-X, vote, and see your ballot. You can see your ballot, and so that you can have a plan to go in there and vote so that you're not, oh my gosh, what's all this other stuff? Need you to know that before. Do some research so that you can be an educated voter. So I'd strongly encourage you to do that. The last, I guess it's not really an announcement, but it is a grand thank you. I want to thank all of you who took your time, and not just yesterday, but took time to prepare and do what you did for my family and I yesterday for the pastor's appreciation. It was, I think I texted Sister Smith this morning, and it was a pressed down, shaken together, running over event, which I'm still not 100% sure we're worthy of, but we are definitely grateful for. The time that everybody spent preparing, practicing, rehearsing, getting everything set up. It's kind of funny because I get a notification anytime somebody logs on this Zoom account, and there were people logging on Zoom all the time. I was like, what's going on? What? I'm not on Zoom. Why is everybody on Zoom? And that was the work that was being done. And so I am so grateful, and I really don't have the words to express how appreciative I am to everybody. Minister Bryant, you had gotten off by the time I got my thank yous yesterday, but thank you for singing yesterday, and the song you sung was 200% appropriate for that. I also want to shout out to the Florida folks that showed up, and I got cards, so I am overwhelmed in the best possible way by the love that you have shown for me and my family, and we are honored to be the pastor of this church, and really honored to be the pastor at this time in history. Because obviously this is something that we've never seen before, but we've got a God who's been there, done that, and he's handing out t-shirts. And so I'm going to get my t-shirt by doing what he has called me to do in this season. And so thank you again for everybody. And for Sister Faye McKinney, I do want to just go ahead. You know, some folks don't like to get their name shouted out. I'm going to shout it out anyway. But you've been online for Bible study and a couple other things. And while I've made sure that I've called out some other folks, I have not said your name out loud. And I wanted to say and thank you for your presence last night and through the other things that we've done. And we're glad to have you as part of this church family while we are doing this distributed worship. And so I think that's all the announcements that I have. And I'm sure somebody's very glad, you know, let the church say amen, and we will go from there. So at this time, and yeah, I'll go ahead and do this. At this time, I would like to invite Sister Elizabeth Williams forward so that she can prepare our hearts and our minds for the word of God to be preached today. Elizabeth, thank you. I'm going to say it now. I'll say it again later, but thank you for being willing to sing and for using the gift that God has given you. Sister Elizabeth Williams.
Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
The king, changes everything.
I'm sorry, let me start over. The devil is busy.
The king
Hold on, Pastor. I apologize.
Take your time.
It's been working all morning till now.